What is in my hand? Please respond. What is in my hand?
Tape.
Can you see?
Tape.
Yeah. Very good. Fine. So it is visible to you all, right? So I have a tape here and I have a ruler. Fine. So what I'll do, is this visible? Is this visible
yes.
to you? Because I cannot
yes,
see
sir.
My video here.
Yeah. Yes,
so
sir, it's visible.
Fine. Okay. So what I'm doing here is, I have this rule and on that I have placed this tape. So what I do, when I roll it without sliding, this is sliding, okay? What I'm doing, I'm rolling it. What I'm doing? I am rolling it without sliding. Yeah. And what I'll do, I will attach a pen on this. A pen I will attach here on the boundary. And then I will rotate it without sliding. Fine. So no skidding is allowed. Fine. It should be purely rotating motion or rolling right. motion. Purely it should be rolling motion. Fine. So when I do that, the path which is drawn by the pen, the path which is drawn by this pen, that path is called as, what is it called as? Krishna, what is it called?
Cycloid.
Cycloid, yes. Cycloid, fine. So many of you will argue, sir, we have now never heard about this. How can you expect us to answer that question? In engineering, actually, what happens, you should come prepared to the class, isn't it? Now the time is over when you used to study only after the lecturer would explain to you each and every step. Now that's not how engineering classes will go. Fine. So actually now you should come prepared to the class. You should read what is the next topic which will be covered in the class, and you should come prepared for this. Right. So this is how the cycloid is going to appear. Fine. So this is the path taken by the. This is the path traveled by a point on the circle. Path traveled by a point on the circle. When the circle rolls without slipping on a straight line. So this line here is the path. What is this line? This line is the path. Fine. And this here is the circle. So what is this circle doing? The circle is rolling without slip on this path. Fine. You can see here. So this is how. Just a minute. Sorry for the disturbance. So, the path traveled by a point on the circle, when the circle rolls without slipping on a straight line. That is called as the cycloid. So this curve here you can see, that is called as the cycloid. Fine. Now, how to draw this cycloid? There are various steps involved. And finally, when you have drawn this completely, this is how it will appear. And for this also, you have to draw a tangent and a normal. You have to draw a tangent and a normal. So after you have drawn everything and after you have applied the different thicknesses, this is how it will appear. So the cycloid has to be the thickest, and circle is slightly less important, so its thickness should be slightly lesser than this. Dimension lines are also important, but their thickness again it has to be medium, right? So all this I have already done in the template file. I have attached the template file in the chat of this meeting also, and if you want, I'll share it on WhatsApp, on your WhatsApp as well. Yeah, so I have shared it on your WhatsApp also. So whichever method you are convenient with, you can download and keep it safely at some location on your computer. Fine. So you can see I have kept it on the desktop itself, so that I can use it whenever I want. As soon as you open that file, you will get it like this. As soon as you open template, what is the first thing we have to do? Anyone? What is the first thing we have to do as soon as we open this? Come on. What is the first thing you have to do? Are you getting my voice clearly? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yeah, I asked a question. What is the first thing we have to do as soon as we open a file? Come on. Very simple answer. Yes? We have to save it. What should we do? We have to save it. Fine. So save it to some location. So what is this one? This is a cycloid. And you students can type your hall ticket number in the name itself. Fine. So now we are ready to create that diagram. So let us take a neat look at this. So where do you think I should start? I have to start with the circle. Fine. And what is the length of this path? What is the length of this line? Anyone? What is the length of this line?
190.
Yes? 190. It's 188.4. How did I calculate that? How did I get it? Anyone? How did I get it?
Circumference of the circle.
Very good. Who is this?
Vishal.
Very good, Vishal. So whenever I ask a question and whoever answers these questions, I'll be allotting some marks to them. Fine. And students who are getting marks in the live class, they need not submit some of the assignments. Fine. So if you don't want to submit assignment, make sure you answer my questions in the live class. Fine. So for one complete rotation, the length which is traveled by the circle will be equal to the circumference. Fine. Equal to the circumference. So total length of the circle is nothing but the circumference. And that length we have to take here. So what is the formula for circumference?
2 pi r.
What's the formula? Yeah, 2 pi r, or yes, or I can write it as pi d. What is d?
Diameter.
Yeah, so if I know the diameter, I can just multiply diameter into pi. If you know the radius, you can go with 2 pi r. So that is how I got this. Fine. Let me confirm. Let me show you that there is no cheating or anything I'm doing. So what is the diameter here of the circle? Diameter of the circle is 60. Multiply that with pi value. How much is pi value? What is the value of pi?
3.14.
Very good. So 60 is the diameter, 3.14. I'm multiplying both. What did I get? 188.4. That's the length I have taken here. Okay?
Yes.
Okay. Fine. So let us begin drawing this. So I'll just take this question. Let me take this question. Keep it here. Fine. So a circle of diameter 60, it's rolling without slipping on a straight line. We have to draw the path traced by point P on the circle. when it rolls for one complete revolution. Let us start that. So diameter of the circle is 60 mm. So I have to take which command? Circle command. So type C, enter, or you can click here and take circle, no problem. Then you have to click on the screen. And now what to do, ma? I want diameter 60. So what to do now?
Type command 60.
Directly type 60.
D enter and 60. D enter and 60.
Yes. Because if we get directly feed 60, this will become radius 60. Do we want radius 60?
No.
Do we want radius as 60?
No.
We want diameter as 60. So when we are drawing that, either we have to calculate the radius and then feed directly, or if you are a little lazy like me, you will directly want to feed diameter. So just choose the option diameter from here, and now you can directly feed diameter. Right. So this circle is wrong because it is having radius 60. This is the correct one. This is having radius 30. Diameter is 60. So this is the correct one. Now we have to draw the path for one complete revolution. For one complete revolution. What is the path? Hello. Yes, ma. Are you getting my voice?
Yes.
Okay. So now we have to draw the path of this. So what should be the length of path? Just now we calculated, now
188.4.
So pi into d value. So d value is 60 into pi, that is 3.1. So now I have to take line command, L enter. Now, which settings should I turn on? Ortho option should be on. And OSNAP settings, all these settings should be on. Nearest and parallel are not required. They will just disturb us. So I have deselected it. Except these two, all other options should be selected. Fine.
Excuse me, sir.
So now, ortho is on. OSNAP is on. I have taken the line command. And now you can see.
Autocorrect, it is not showing, sir.
If it is not showing, then maybe this button is off.
Okay.
Please ensure that this button is on. And also, even when it is on, if it is not showing, then you just click on this small arrow here.
Okay.
Fine. All these options should be selected. Only then it will display. So whatever options we have selected here, they will be displayed. Whatever options are not selected, they will not be displayed. Yeah. Once again, I have taken line command. Ortho option is on. OSNAP option is on. I will start at this point. What is this point called? Quadrant. What is it called? Quadrant. Now, from quadrant, I have to take a horizontal line. Now, ortho option is on, so I am getting exactly horizontal line. So, what should be the length? We calculated it. 188.4. Clear? Is there a lag in the voice?
No, sir.
Okay. Because it seems that you people are receiving my voice a little after I have already spoken. Anyway, so let us continue. So we have drawn the length of this. So how much is the length? 188.4. Correct. Now again, let's take line command. We have to draw from center up to bottom. From center up to bottom, we have to draw a line. Now, we have to divide this circle and this line into same number of parts. So how many parts you want to take? How many parts can you see here in this diagram?
Two.
Yes, ma'am. How many parts can you see in this diagram? 1, 2, 3, 4. What is the last one? 12 parts. So we have to take 12 parts here. Fine. So for this, I will not use divide command. For circle, I will not use divide command. What command should I use? Array. Okay. So I have selected the line. I gave the array command, chosen polar option, and now center point I have to click. You can see by default it is giving us 6 number of copies. That we can change from here. From the top here, we can change that. How much we want? 12. How much we want? We want 12. Done. Next, what to do, ma? Next, what to do? I will take a line. I will draw a straight line. Escape. Again, line command. From here, take a straight line, perpendicular. Escape. Extra line, you can trim it. What is the trim command?
TR.
TR.
Enter. Shift.
Not enter, double enter. Many students will get confused here. Fine. They press enter only one time and they say, sir, trim command is not working. They have to press enter two times. They have to press enter two times. Be careful with that. Okay. So now I have covered this. Now what to do? I will just skip the naming part. Naming part, you can just copy this. Copy paste this and you can do the naming part. Fine. I think you people are perfect with this. You can continuously use Control V for pasting this and then double click on it to name it. 2, this is 3, this is 4, and so on. Okay. So do the naming and all on your own. I will just save time. I won't do all that. Okay. So now I have to take a line command. Now I have to take a line command. Now from this end point, can you see this end point? From this end point, I have to draw a straight line up to perpendicular. Escape. Again, enter. From this point, again draw a straight line up to perpendicular. Escape. Again, take this point, draw straight, perpendicular. Do the same for all these. Okay. Till here, everything is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, okay, this line, I will move it to the center. This line should start at center and end at this point. Okay. So now this line, I will divide it into how many parts?
12.
How many parts?
12 parts.
So this is 4, 5, 6, this is 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Fine. So I have to divide this into 12 parts. How to divide this one? Which command?
DIV.
Okay. Now click on the line and then feed 12, enter. Okay. Now you can see the line has been divided, but it is not visible. What to do now?
P type,
very good. The P type you have to change. Choose a different style for the point. Make it absolute. And the size you can just make it 2 mm. Click OK. Now you can see all the points are now visible.
Yes.
Okay. Now I can pick this, copy, paste. And what do we call these points? We have to call it as C. C is for center. C is for center. So I have to make this as C1. Now I'll copy this, paste. Fine. So I'm continuously copy pasting all at this at different points. And what I have to do next? This value I have to change. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Just double click on this, change the value, click in the empty place. and then you just have to click once, 8, click here, and click here, 9, click here. So same way you can continue doing this till everything is done. The last point, what this last point will be? 12. So all the center points are named.
Sure.
Now we have to copy this circle. You have to copy this circle, or you can just move the circle. You can move it also, no problem. So I'll select this circle. Center point, I will move to C1. Where ma? Center point, I'll move to C1. Now, this is the intersection point we need, not this. Fine. So intersection between the circle and this line. So I will keep a point there. Command for point is PO enter. What is the command for point? PO enter. So I will keep a point at the intersection. Fine. Now the same thing I should continue doing. Same thing I should continue doing for all the points. So from C1 on the first line, then move it to C2. C2. So from C2 on the second line. This is the second line. This is the circle. So at their intersection, I have to keep a point. Again, move it. 3. So 3 with third line. So this intersection point. PO, this intersection. Then move to 4. Again, PO enter, intersection. Again, move this to 5. This is the fifth line. And then 6. Sixth line, it is just touching here. Okay. Then 7. Seventh one, again, we have to come down from the right side. So this is the point. Any doubts here? If you have any doubt, let me know. Circle, move the center, PO enter, keep it. This is the next point. Next, PO enter here. Then C11 is this one. Be careful with these two points. One of the points is for the cycloid. The second, this was the previously drawn point. This is the center point. This is for the cycloid. So circle should be kept at C11, not on this point. So this should match with this line. So PO, this intersection point. And the last one, 12, will come here, exactly. It will come here, exactly. Fine. So we got all these points. How many points we got, ma'am?
12
points we got. Now this circle work is over. Let us move this circle back to its starting position. Over. So this circle, we rolled it at all these points and we found all the 12 points on the path taken by this circle. So now we have to join all these points. So which command we have to use to join all these points?
Spline, SPL.
SPL, spline, smooth polyline. Spline full form is smooth polyline. So spline command I have to give. I have to start here at the bottom. Then all these points that I have drawn, those I have to join. Fine. So be careful here. There are two points. One point is for center point. The other point is for the path. We should not take the center point. We should take the path point. Fine. Let me just turn off the ortho so that you can see how it's happening. So all these points I have to join. So here, this right side point is center point. So left side point I have to take. Fine. So all these points I have to. Once I have joined all these points, what to do now?
Turn on ortho.
Press enter. Fine. When you are drawing a spline, if you press escape, it will go away. Fine. So when you are drawing a spline, after you are done doing spline, you have to press enter. Only then the spline will stay. If you press escape, it will go away. If you press escape, it will go away. fine. So be careful with that. Be careful with that. So this is clear. So this curve that we got here, that is called as the cycloid. That is called as the cycloid. Fine. Now on this cycloid, we have to draw tangent and normal. So if the point where you have to draw tangent and normal, if it is not given, you can draw it wherever you want. But in our question, you can see, is he mentioning where we have to draw this point? So where we have to draw? You can see here, draw tangent and normal to the curve at a point S. Where is this point S? It is 50 mm above the bottom line. 50 mm above the bottom line. Above the bottom line, or you can call it as road, or the plane on which our circle is rolling. Right? We have to find the angle rotation. So this is the next part. So first, let us draw the tangent and normal at this point. So where? We have to draw it 50 mm above the line. Fine. So our bottom line means this line is the bottom line. So from this line, we need a distance of how much? 50 mm. We need a distance of 50 mm. So let us take it. So the command which I'll be using here is offset. What is the command for offset? O, enter. What is the command for offset? O, enter. Fine. So I'll just note down the commands that I've used here. So which commands I've used? Array command I've used. Next. Array command, then command. Divide command. Divide command, next. Yes, ma'am?
Spline command.
Spline command, okay. Spline command. What is the shortcut? SPL. Then?
Point command.
I have done copy pasting, I have done. Then?
P type.
And now I'm using offset. Offset shortcut is O. Offset shortcut is O. Now I have to type O, enter. Fine. And what should be the distance? Distance should be 50 mm. Distance should be 50 mm. So O, enter, 50, enter. O, enter, 50, enter. Click on the bottom line and click above. Fine. So this line is at what distance? This line from the bottom, it is at what distance? 50 mm distance?
Mm-hmm.
Now at this 50 mm distance, this is where it is intersecting. This is where it is intersecting. So what is that point? This point here is yes. What is that point? This point here is yes. Okay. That point here is yes. So at this point, we have to draw tangent and normal. We have to draw tangent and normal. Now listen carefully. What is the procedure for drawing tangent and normal? In the involutes, especially in the polygonal involutes, we had parts of a circle or arcs. So with arcs, we just joined the center point with that particular point and we directly got as the normal. And then to that, we have drawn perpendicular to get tangent. For circular involute, it was slightly different. And I hope you have seen that in the video also. And here, the procedure is slightly different. Fine. So what you have to do, we have to use this circle once again. Fine. So select this circle, its center point. We first move it to the point S. Center point of the rolling circle, move it to point S. Now, we will get its intersection with the center line. We will get it at two points. At two points, it will intersect. So we should not use this side point. We have to use this side point. We have to use this side point. Right. Now, how to identify which side to use? When we start naming, you know, when we are giving the names, we have to call this first point as P1, second point P2, third point P3, P4, then P5, P6, P7, this point is P7, this point is P8. Okay. So like this, you have to give the namings. Now this point is between P7 and P8. No? This point, yes, is between P7 and P8. Same way, we have to take the intersection between C7 and C8. And this point is between 10 and 11. We should not take this. We should not take this. Right. So be careful where you are taking. And then this is our point. What is this point? That point is just C, the center point. Now this, the work of this circle is over. What we should do? We should pick this point, keep it back. Right. Now take line command. Join the point S with the point C. And then take a straight line downwards. Straight line downwards. And then join this point here. Fine. So once again, take line command. Join the point S with the point C, which we found using the circle. And then draw a straight line downwards. Perpendicular, you can take. And then join back here. Press escape. Now, this line is the normal. So I'll pick this line from the midpoint. Keep it here. Fine. And now I want to draw the tangent. How to draw tangent? Anyone?
Arrow.
Arrow enter.
Yes, arrow enter. So that's another command which we are doing. So, rotate. Arrow. Fine. So we are rotating a copy of that. Be careful. We are rotating a copy of that. Fine. So what we should do? Select the line. Arrow enter. Then select at this point. Then right click. Copy. And then give the angle. Angle is 90 degrees. Fine. So this line that we got is a tangent. And this line that we got is the normal. So you can take another line and join this. Yeah. So this line is different, this line is different. Fine. So now I have to apply all the properties. What properties I have to apply? Use match properties. Solid should be applied to the curve, to the tangent and normal. This is tangent, this is normal. Okay. Then dimension properties should be applied to circle, to the path on which it is traveling. And whatever dimensions you are drawing, for all of them, you have to apply dimensions. Okay. So anything else he is asking? So we have solved this problem up to here. So this complete up to here, we have solved it. Now, this part remains here. So find the angle rotated and the distance traveled by the circle up to yes. Fine. So when the circle comes to this point, by what angle the circle has rotated, that we have to find out. Fine. So how to do that? How to do that? Fine. So I have already told, can you see my video? Can you see my video?
Sir.
Yeah. So I have already told, when it is rolling, it will roll without the slip. It will roll without the slip. So at any point, we have to find the angle rotated. Fine. So initially here, this is the point. So when it rolls, this point comes here. Now with reference to the vertical line, what is the angle turned? We have to find that. Fine. So now, if we take this line here, when the circle comes to this point, fine. When the circle comes here, the line which was here in the beginning has rotated and it has come here. Fine. So this total is the angle which is turned by. Right. So that is the angle turned by. So go to dimensions option. And in the dimensions, choose angle. And click on these two lines. What is the angle rotated? What is the angle rotated?
32.
Come on, tell me.
132 degrees.
Is it correct? Is that the angle turned? No. Actually, this here reflex angle we have to take.
132 minus 360, sir.
360 minus 130. 132.
Oh, sorry. 360 minus 132.
360 minus 132. So how much angle it has turned? 228 degrees. Fine. What is the answer? 228 degrees. Fine. So answer you can write like this. Angle turned equal to how much? 228 degrees. Okay. So this is how we have to solve cycloid problem. Is it clear? Now, when it comes to cycloid, there are many variations in the question. Fine. So this is one type in which he can ask the same question. He can twist slightly and he may say that the point P is at the top in the beginning. Fine. So in this previous problem, we assumed that the point was starting at the bottom. But if the point starts at the top, then what happens? This will be the path. This is the path taken by our cycloid. Clear? This is how the path will look like. And if there are some other points, like here, the starting points are at P and Q. So we are getting two cycloids. One cycloid for P, the other cycloid for Q. Okay. So like this, the question may be twisted. And here, what is happening here? For half of the rotation, the circle is moving on horizontal path. And after that, it is moving on vertical path. Fine. So then this is how the path will appear. And once again here, we are assuming that the point is at the bottom initially. Instead of at the bottom, if the point is at the top, then we will get the path like this. Are you getting it? So all these are different variations of the problem on cycloid. Fine. So I hope everyone will be able to solve this and submit this. Fine. So next assignment will be on cycloids. There are three types of cycloids. One is what you have seen just now. This is called as a cycloid, simply a cycloid. And if the path is not a straight line, instead of straight line, if the path is a circle, path is also a circle. And the rolling object is also a circle. So if this circle is rolling on this circle, then we get this path. This path here is called as epicycloid. Epi means outside. And this is how that will appear. Fine. And same way, if the path is larger, and the rolling circle is rolling inside. Fine. Then this is how the path will appear. And this part is called, what is it called?
Hypo.
So all three we should be able to draw. Fine. So as you can see here, there are a lot of variations. Fine. So in this case, what is happening? The rolling circle and the path, they are of same size. If they are of same size, we will get a heart shape like this. Fine. So this is also epicycloid. Fine. And if we have the path as double radius of the rolling circle, then the path will be exactly a straight line. Then the path will be exactly a straight line. So this is the hypocycloid here. Fine. And finally, here I have shown how the teeth of epicyclic gears are formed. Epicyclic gears, they are formed by two parts. Fine. So the upper part will be epicycloid. The lower part will be hypocycloid. Fine. So both these will be used to form the teeth of the epicyclic gear. Fine. So you will learn about the gears in detail in another subject called kinematics of machines, which you will have in second year. Okay. So in this subject, your aim should be to learn how to draw different objects. Fine. When it comes to learning more about it theoretically, you will learn more in the coming subjects in the next few years. Okay. So that's it for this class. Hope you will solve this completely. Watch this video again if you want. I will upload this on the YouTube channel. Link to this I'll share in your WhatsApp group. And fine. Now you can start practicing. Okay, I'll just stop the recording. Just stop the recording.